In today's video, we will be discussing what is string slicing, syntax of string slicing, scenario 1 with no step size, scenario 2 with no stop index, scenario 3 with no start index, scenario 4 with no start and stop index, scenario 5 with no start, step or stop index, and scenario 6 with single character as a substring. Hey champions, if you are interested in these topics, then keep on watching. You can subscribe to our channel for more such videos. Let's start with the basics first. What exactly is slicing? In real life, a slice means a part of something, like a pizza or a fruit, and the process of cutting a slice is known as slicing. Similarly, a slice of a string is a part of the string, and the process of grabbing a part of the string is known as string slicing. In real life, slicing is done using a knife or a sharp material, while slicing in Python is done using the slicing operator, which is the colon. The slicing syntax has three numeric values in it, each separated by colons and surrounded by square brackets. The first part of the syntax is the start, which is the first index of the substring you want to grab. Then comes a colon, which is followed by stop. The stop is the last index up to which you want to grab your substring. But remember, the last index will not be included in the substring. This is again followed by a colon, which is then followed by the step size. Here, step size is the size of the jump you want to take while grabbing the subsection from the string. We have covered string indexing in detail in one of our videos. If you are interested in the topic, then the link is in the description box. Let's take some example to fully understand string slicing. For our first example, we have a string learning champion from which we want to grab the substring champ. Now we need three indexes in order to grab this substring. Let's first find out the start index. As you can see, the start index of the substring we want to grab is 8. Next, we need the stop index, which is 13 in our case. Here, the stop index is 13 because we want to grab the substring up to the 13th index but not include the 13th element. The last is the step size, which will be 1 because we want to pick all the letters from the index 8 to 13. Now that we have all the parts of the syntax, let's see if our desired substring is returned when we run this code. As you can see, after running this code, the output is indeed champ. Now moving on to the scenario 1 with no step size. Note that the default step size in Python is 1. That is, if we don't even mention anything in the step size, Python will assume that our step size is 1. Let us test this claim. Here, we have written myString 8 to 13 without mentioning any step size. And as you can see, Python has returned the substring champ as a result. This shows that Python will assume the step size as 1 by default in case it is not mentioned. It was fun, wasn't it? Let's try to play with some more scenarios. Scenario 2, no stop index. Now let's see what will happen when we only put the start index without the stop index. Here, I have put the starting index as 8 and have not given any stop index. When I run this code, Python outputs the substring champion, which signifies that it has assumed the last index of the string as the stop index by default. Hence, in a scenario where we don't specify any stop index, Python assumes the very last index of the string as the stop index by default. Scenario 3, no start index. Let's consider another scenario, where this time I will not give the starting index but will only give the stop index while grabbing the substring. Here, as you can see, I have given 13 as the stop index without any start index. Let's see how Python will resolve it. When I execute this command, the output is learning champ, which shows that Python has automatically assumed the starting index as 0. Hence, in a scenario where we don't specify any starting index, Python assumes it as 0 by default. Scenario 4, no start or stop index. The next scenario is where we don't specify the start or the stop index, but give the step size as 2. In such a scenario, as discussed previously, Python will assume the starting index as 0 and the stop index as the end of the string. But since we have now given the step size, it will return every alternate character after skipping the two characters in between. Scenario 5. No start, step or stop index. Let us now consider a peculiar scenario where we neither mention the start index, stop index nor the step size in the syntax while grabbing the substring. At first glance, you might think that this is not a valid syntax, but to your surprise, it is completely valid. In such a scenario, Python will assume the starting index as 0, stop index as the end of the string and step size as 1. Hence, when we execute this command, it will return the whole string back as the output. Scenario 6. single character as a substring. The next scenario is where we want to index a single character using the slicing operator. For such a case, remember the difference between the start and the stop index should be 1, and the start index should be equal to the position at which the character is present in the original string. For example, if we want to get C from our string learning champion, then we will write mystring 8 to 9. That's it for today's video. I hope this video cleared all your doubts regarding the string slicing with a positive index. We will cover the string slicing with a negative index in our upcoming video. You can share your thoughts or questions in the comment box. Subscribe for more such videos. Bye, and meet you in the next one.